Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Adam. This is my channel, Adam Sews, and this is this week's Friday Sews. Right, so my aim was to get this out, well, not get this out early, but was to actually get this recorded early, but much to my normal life, I like to leave everything till the last minute when it comes to Friday Sews. So it is early Friday morning. I am running around like a headless chicken. My parents are back from holiday today. I'm going to go and see my mum before I go to Newcastle tomorrow for Sewtoon on Sunday. So I am working my way up the country tomorrow. I'm going to stop en route, and I'm going to see the lovely Judy from Running So and So, and I get to meet her dogs, and I am really, really excited to meet her. We are going to have some tea and cake with Rachel from Stitched Up, I believe. So that will be amazing. And then I'm going to wander off and I'm going to carry on up the country a little bit further to Newcastle, where I'm going to check into my hotel. And then I am going to go and spend some time tomorrow evening with the lovely Michelle. Michelle's in America. That would be a very long drive. I'm going to spend a lovely evening with Lucy from Geek Petite, with Rachel from Stitched Up, the lovely Ruan from the Yorkshire Sew Girl, and Tamlin from Sew Normal Time. So I get to have a lovely evening with them all before we all go to Sewtoon on Sunday. So I'm really looking forward to that. If you haven't checked out any of their YouTube channels, they will all be linked down below. So please go and check them all out. If you haven't seen their YouTube channels, you must go and look at them, because they are amazing. Sorry, I'm trying to think of a million things at the same time and my brain's running on a bit of a slow go this morning. So what have I been making this week? Well, I haven't made much at all this week. Work has been really busy. I've been trying to get my head around everything that I've got planned for the weekend, trying to get stuff packed away so that I don't leave everything till the last minute, which hasn't actually worked because I need to go and pack in a minute. But I have got some sewing done. I'll show you the first thing, because the first thing's already been sold, gone. It's going up with me because the beautiful Ruan from the Yorkshire Sew Girl has bought this beautiful project bag that I made. It has got the Tulip Pink Saturdays quilt back in fabric on the back, which is just beautiful. It's got these little rays of sunshine and rainbows. And then the front is a big vinyl pocket which unzips, so you can fit all of your projects in here. So that's that. I am working on a second one, which is a combination of Alison Glass and Kay Facet. So it's got a Kay Facet band across the top, and the back of it is a big log cabin block from Alison Glass and some Kona Solid. So this is going to have a matching binding to the binding that's on the zip, and it's got the oil slick vinyl on the front, and the inside of the pocket is Alison Glass trinkets to match the back, but in a different colourway. So that will be finished probably not this weekend, at some point next week, and we'll go up at my store. I don't know if I made these this week or last week or whatever, or I finished them this week, but this is another smaller project bag. This is made from Everglow, so it's got all the stripe binding from the new Neon True Colours. It's got the glitter vinyl on the front. It has the giraffes on the inside. The back of it is the beautiful new neon fairy flakes. And this is one of the project bags, which is on my store. This is actually in a set of three. So you get this one, you get the smaller, slightly smaller one, which this is really good for quilt blocks. Because that'll probably fit like anything up to sort of like a 6 or 7 inch quilt block in there. This has got some of the homemade fabric on it, some of the True Colours binding, and some of the fairy flakes on the inside with the glitter vinyl on the front. So as you can see, they're sort of all tied together with the binding. And then the last one is this little pouch, which I made a little while ago. And this is the giraffes as well, which matches in here. And this is actually lined with fairy flakes in here, and then the front pocket is a little clear vinyl pocket, and it's perfect for putting things like scissors, threads, and so such and so forth. So if you're going anywhere, like on a retreat, you can pack all of your different things into there in a little set and take them all with you. The other thing that I made was some of these little quilted pouches. So these are just little like quilt wallet things, which are perfect to put in your handbag with your phone and a credit card and some cash maybe, or pop in all of those things in there, maybe with a house key, picking them up and then being able to just carry just that little pouch. So this one is Moon Garden. It's got some of the snakes on the back of it and then some of the different colourways of Moon Garden on the front. And the other one is just sort of like a, it's just a scrappy Tula mix. So it's mainly neon true colours. It's got a bit of homemade in there. And then the back of it is the fairy flakes. Again, it unzips at the front. And this one has got the rainbows in there from Daydreamer. So they are those. And as I say, that's about it really. Not really any more sewing than that this week. So I am going to go now. I'm going to sort myself out because this is not attractive, and no one wants to see the state of this as I get out of bed. So I need to go and have a shower, get ready, get packed, go and see my mum, get home, spend the evening with my lovely husband because I won't see him for 2 days. And then I will get up early and get on my merry way. I have washed my car ready because I don't like driving anywhere with a dirty car. So I did that yesterday. Which took way longer than I thought it was going to, because I ended up then going around and doing some little touch-ups with some little stone chips that I had, because the paint that is on my car, the manufacturer that makes my car make paint that is made from cheese. So the minute anything touches it, the paint just goes, ah, I don't want to be attached to your car anymore, and tries to remove itself. So yeah, that's that. But besides that, I haven't really been up to much. I did try and tidy up in here, but that never worked. I have got an extensive amount of 505 quilting spray now because I did do a wholesale order this week. So all of my stuff came in. So I've got 505 delivered. I've got another roll of foam delivered. And I also got some more of the quilting needles and another tailor's oil, because I use my oil all the time. And I'm scared that if I, which is this one here, I'll show you about the packet, it's the clover oil. This is what I use for all of my binding, and I got one of these for So Carol because she was making quite a lot of bags of binding and was saying about how much it hurts her fingers. So if you do any amount of binding, one of these is the best oil that you can buy. It's got, the only thing I would say is it's super, super sharp. So if you slip off your binding and stab yourself, it makes you bleed. But for any type of binding, it's also, to be honest, if you haven't got one, they are literally, I think they're about £4 or £5. They are like having a second hand, like an 11th finger, shall we say, because you can actually get everything right in near, right near the needle into the presser foot without getting, without sewing through your finger. So if you're trying to position like the end of a piece of bias binding, you can literally pull it over the seam, hold it down with that, and then feed it right in towards the needle so it catches and doesn't flip out of the way or slide. So they are really, really helpful. So top tip, if you're going to look for any new sewing tools, get an awl. And I would also recommend the clover one because the point on the awl is really, really strong and really, really not bendy, basically. It doesn't bend, whereas a lot of the other ones are quite flexible, and I just don't trust them. I think they're gonna snap. The other thing that I got as well was some of the number 12 quilt in betweens needles, which are also made by Clover. These are black. They're specially polished with a black plating, so they pierce smoothly through the fabric. You get 6 needles in a pack. These are a number 12, and they've got a gold eye on them, which you can sort of see here. That's a big blown up version of them. But these are really, really tough, and they are brilliant for English paper piecing and any small hand stitching projects that you've got, really. The only thing I would say is these are a lot firmer than the clover, not the clover, the tulip needles for English paper piecing. So if you don't get on with the tulip needles, which I unfortunately don't, even though I have got 2 packs of them and they are extortionately expensive, these are the next best thing, and I actually prefer these, and I would never go back to using clover needles now I've found these. Not clover needles, tulip needles. The clover ones are the better and far superior. So there you go. There's just some random chit-chat about random stuff that may or may not interest you, but I will speak to you all soon. Have a good weekend, and I will give you a little catch-up next week of what I've been up to over the weekend while I'm at SOTU. See you all soon. Take care. Bye.